Uganda is currently a home for over 1.6 million refugees from across the globe. However, the Ministry for Relief, Disaster Preparedness and Refugees is concerned with the dwindling relief support from the international community. Hilary Onek, the line minister, says the World Food Organization has trimmed its food relief support to Uganda by about 70%, leaving refugees to survive on one meal a day.
The World Food Program has cut down the ration of food for feeding the refugees we are hosting to only 30 or less percent, to about 30%, meaning the refugees we are hosting here can only have one meal a day.
Onek says the reduced food support has seen a wave of criminality booming in refugee hosting communities as some refugees struggle to find a living. He blames the food shortage on the Russia-Ukraine war, where international organizations have shifted their attention and neglected Africa.
And of course, when resources become small, Africans are thought of last. The priority is elsewhere. Africans are handled last. Sort of last. And that is a scenario our new board is coming into. Facing a scenario where you're incapacitated. And now when you people are incapacitated, you are now handling a situation which is riddled with falsehood. Because if somebody is not able to eat, and somebody reduced to survival, nobody will tell you the correct story.
The minister warned that the influx of refugees is not about to reduce, warning that the Russia-Ukraine war is likely to escalate into a third world war, and blamed it on the USA and some European powers, which he accuses of being greedy.
The world has become more turbulent. We are actually at the brink of world war, where possibilities that there will be no survival. Because if they start using nuclear weapons, nobody will survive on Earth. And they're aging closer to that. Because every morning, every evening, I'm monitoring, following what's happening. And these are all because of greed. Nothing except greed. Greed from Americans and the West. Capitalist world, very greedy. They want to grab everything.
The outgoing chairperson of the Refugee Appeals Board, Gordon Lakidi, warned the incoming leadership of the upsurge of applications for asylum stemming from the ongoing Sudanese civil war, while the incoming chairperson, Charles Wadenya, pledged to execute the mandate at hand with utmost due diligence.
And for the new board, there are more challenges now. We have the heavy influx of refugees from Sudan following the strife that is taking place there. Of course, we still have the constant inflows from DRC, and then I think maybe a trickle from Southern Sudan.
To the work of the government of Uganda and the Honorable Minister have accorded us another opportunity to serve this dear department. We are also grateful that we've had very good cooperation with our department on the Apollo Kangwa Road. The commissioner has always been helpful, has always been around with his staff to come and tell us where we have got a problem here and there.
According to the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, 367 cases of asylum seekers are pending disposal by the board. The five-member tribunal entertains cases of appeal for asylum rejected by the Refugee Eligibility Committee. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.